Much obliged. Got it!
The shop. What you asked me to do.
Let's not discuss it.
No. What did that thing do to you?
If he were to take me back, that's death, Mr. DeWitt. Or something so like it, I cannot tell the difference.
Dangerous measures. Protect your women and your treasures.
Here's some cash.
You got empty pockets? Best way on walk.
Now!
On it!
There! That one!
Done! time to look.
Not getting out of here alive.
Need these salts? Looker here!
Perfect timing!
That's all I have right now. Watch yourself up. Here you go.
That'll do. Go ahead.
Done. Found some money. Thinking about that dream that you had. New York on fire. There's something about it. Beyond that gate lies Comstock House.
Lady Comstock, how lovely to see you. Wonderful of you to make the journey, especially considering your painful death 19 years ago.
Lady Comstock.
The dress. The thing has mistaken me for my mother.
Your fingerprints do not seem to be your own today, Lady Comstock. Are you unwell?
This isn't going to work.
I think it can.
Your mother's dead, Elizabeth.
Yes. It's time I paid my respects. Let's head to where she's buried. There's the graveyard where my mother's buried.
Where are you going?
Come on.
What are we looking for? Go ahead!
There.
That's your mother's grave.
They have her preserved in an airtight chamber. Her fingerprints will get us into Comstock House.
She's your mother.
A mother who abandons their child doesn't draw a lot of sympathy in my book.
Take a moment to think about what you're doing.
There. Will you open the door, or do I have to go in without you?
Elizabeth.
It's her. How are you, Mother? All locked up in there, huh? Looks like you and I have some common ground. No.
Let me do it.
Look on the other side.
And he has led you astray. What I do, I do for love. What lion does not cringe to see their cub in pain? But spare the rod, spoil the child. If you won't listen to me, perhaps you will listen to your mother.
Elizabeth, are you all right?
Where did she go?
Just hold on. You need to rest for a minute.
No, I'm getting that hand.
Elizabeth, why is your mother a ghost?
She's not. He used me to power that device. He opened up some kind of tear.
Save your mother! It's raising the dead! Come!
Now! Tripping! what am I? My God. Is she the source of my power?
But what is she? Alive or dead?
Why do you ask what?
When the delicious question is when.
The only difference between past and present
is semantics.
Lives, lived, will live.
Dies, died, will die.
If we could perceive time as it truly was,
what reason would grammar professors have to get out of bed?
Like us all, Lady Comstock exists across time.
She is both alive and dead.
She perceives being both.
She finds this condition disagreeable.
Perception without comprehension
is a dangerous combination. Look! Footsteps. She goes to unfinished business.
We have to follow her. Convince her to open the gate to Comstock House.
Need of her to enter Comstock House.
Frankly, she doesn't seem all that cooperative.
There is a way to bring her to reason.
Three truths you must discover first.
Truths which, in this world, Comstock has destroyed.
If only one of you had the power to alter time and space.
That would be a blessing, wouldn't it?
They're sarcastic.
There's something off about Lady Comstock.
Yeah, I noticed.
No, you don't understand. She doesn't belong here. I brought something through. I'm not so sure it was her.
I appreciate a lady who appreciates value.
Need money? Okay, cash.
No one gets out alive!
That's all I have right now!
I'll cut you in half!
Schultz, catch!
Don't stop!
Booker, catch!
Got it!
There's no getting out of this!
That's all I've got! Here! Ammo! Take it!
Crack this one open.
Sure thing. Ready.
Non-existent.
And Madame Lutèce?
Furthermore, the man is quite sterile. It's a lie. Come here, you little bastard! I want her out of my house!
Sterile?
They were my parents.
Then what were you to them?
Just